This video demonstrates how to harvest data from the Digital Commons Author Dashboard for departmental reports. Scholarly contributions at Georgia Southern that are added to Digital Commons help demonstrate departmental productivity and research impact. Built into the platform are author dashboards that collect PlumX metrics, readership, and usage data. These metrics are drawn from a variety of online sources, including where a work is published, shared, or referenced. Data harvested from author dashboards can be useful for things like annual reports, writing grant applications to support accreditation, and as a selling feature to attract future faculty and students. To view and harvest data from the author dashboard, log in with the email address and password associated with your selected works account. You can either go directly to the URL, dashboard.bpress.com, and log in, or you can navigate there from the Digital Commons homepage at digitalcommons.georgiasouthern.edu and click on the link to selected works profiles. After clicking on selected works profiles, you'll see the expert gallery landing page. From there, go to the menu in the top right corner to log in. Then navigate to the main menu to select author dashboard. The author dashboard has screens for viewing three different types of data, including Digital Commons readership, Digital Commons usage, and PlumX metrics. Use the dashboard tabs along the left side to switch between these three screens. When you arrive at the author dashboard, it defaults to all works in the academic unit for the entire time they've been in the repository. Across the top of the author dashboard are two filters. Use the filters to modify by specific pieces of research or specific timeframes for works within your college or department. The works filter includes a search box and a drop-down menu to select from, allowing administrators to either view all of their academic units' works or data for specific works. And with the date range filter, you can gather metrics for annual reports or a specific time frame by selecting the custom monthly range. Readership and usage tabs feature widgets that allow you to gather specific types of data. Widgets throughout the dashboard include a search box and an export button in the top right corner. Click the export button to download a CSV or character separated value file of the contents of that widget, and then open the file in a spreadsheet program like Excel. On the readership tab, widgets show where and how people are discovering works in Digital Commons. The dashboard map displays download counts in geographic clusters. You can zoom in and out, drag the map, and click on clusters for more details. Below the map is the institutions widget that displays organizations, universities, and other settings where full text works have been downloaded. The countries widget shows how many countries have downloaded full text and each country's total downloads. Click on the arrow to the left of each country to view the top articles being downloaded by that country. And the majority of traffic to Digital Commons comes from search engines like Google and Google Scholar. Use the referrers widget to see the source of inbound traffic to full text documents. To view usage reports, navigate to the left side dashboard tabs and click on the second icon from the top. The first usage widget displays the number of file downloads from Digital Commons of materials posted for your department. Below that is the widget for metadata page hits. Metadata is a description of the work. It's the title, author, publication year, etc. And this widget shows how many people looked at the metadata for that item. And the works table at the bottom shows a list of all published works. You can click on the title of the work to show data only for that specific work, or you can click on the external link icon to the left to visit that work in Digital Commons. PlumX provides citations and altmetrics organized in 5 categories. These categories include citations, usage, such as how many times a work has been downloaded, how many full text views it's received, and how many times a video recording has been played. Captures, when people are saving or bookmarking an item for later. Mentions, when people are talking about works in blogs, news sources, reviews, and sources like Wikipedia. And social media, also known as altmetrics. The PlumX snapshot features tiles for each of these 5 types of metrics. Click on one of the tiles and it sorts the results into the PlumX metrics table below. Then use the arrows on one of the column headings to sort by a specific metric type. The table will rank works in the order of most views where data activity was collected for that type of metric. From there, you can click on the title of the work to get a summary of PlumX metrics that piece of research has accrued, like usage, captures, and social media. And at this time, PlumX is the only tab that's not affected by the date range filter, which means data for PlumX will be set to all time, going back as far as data exists for your works. The author dashboard provides insight into how people are engaging with scholarly output. Digital Commons readership shows the countries and institutions that are discovering and using research for your department. Digital Commons usage provides the number of file downloads and metadata page visits for works in Digital Commons. And PlumX metrics captures metrics across 5 categories, including citations and social media sharing. Administrators may want to use this data as a component of identifying opportunities to increase research visibility and impact. If you have any questions or would like assistance using the author dashboard in Digital Commons for departmental reports, please contact me, Beth Burnett, the Institutional Repository Librarian at nburnett@georgiasouthern.edu. Thank you for watching.